we gather tonight, we are reminded that one of the classic hymns associated with the season of Lent, Scottish-born writer James Montgomery, the author of over 400 hymns, penned this thoughtful prayer. In the hour of trial, Jesus, plead for me, lest by base denial I depart from thee. Although the language of the hymn reflects the era in which it was written, almost 200 years ago, the central concern is as valid today as it was when the stanza was written. The phrase, base denial, calls to mind the disciple Peter, who disowned his Lord while in the courtyard of the house of the high priest. At times in our lives, we may be tempted to deny our Lord and to act as though our faith is not central to who we are. It is then that we can draw strength. studying his face intently until she blurted out, "This man also is with him." Peter jumped, he turned to her, and for the first time, Peter took stock of where he was. He looked around at the crowd gathered in that courtyard and realized that these folks, those that were gathered all around, weren't at all that friendly to his group of friends. He hoped to shut her down without drawing further attention to himself. So he looked at her and said, "Oh no, ma'am, I don't know him." That seemed to satisfy her. So he returned to watch the events unfolding inside. There was more arguing. Raised voices, accusations were being shouted across the room. Peter shivered. He wasn't sure whether it was from the cold or from a sense of foreboding. That pesky woman had moved on, but a young man had taken her spot, and he was looking at Peter. "You're one of them too." Peter was a little irritated. He needed these people to quit interrupting his concentration. He was trying to hear what was happening to Jesus. "Man, I am not," he said. The young man seemed to take that at face value, and he too walked away. Although Peter noticed him a little later, whispering with a group of men off in the corner of the courtyard. Still, his eyes were riveted on Jesus and the proceedings inside. Time passed. It was late at night, or maybe even early in the morning. Peter had lost track of time. He couldn't tell exactly what was happening, but it didn't seem good. There was a lot of yelling, and the high priest had been carrying on for a while and was obviously agitated, and that's when it happened. From across the courtyard, the voice rang out. As soon as the man began speaking, Peter knew it was about him. He was standing and pointing at Peter. "I'm telling you, this guy was with him. I heard him talking earlier, and he is definitely from Galilee. His accent gives him away." All eyes turned to Peter. He wasn't sure how to react or what even to say. What if they realized he really was with Jesus? Would they arrest him too? He didn't know, and he didn't want to find out. He figured if he responded aggressively, maybe they would stop saying it. "Man, I do not know what you are talking about." He spit each word out in turn, hoping this guy would just back down. The courtyard grew quiet, and Peter heard a rooster crowing in the distance. Peter just glared at his accuser for a moment and then turned to see what was going on inside. It was like Jesus knew what was happening outside, even though he was up to his neck with the council. Slowly, Jesus turned and made eye contact with Peter. His eyes were sad. They were accusing. And Peter remembered what Jesus had said about denying him three times before the rooster crowed. Tears welled up in Peter's eyes as he pushed through the crowd. He had to get out of that place. He couldn't face Jesus after what he had done. He was so embarrassed, so lost. What did this mean? How often do you do the same thing? Fail to acknowledge your faith in public because you're scared of how people will react. Or maybe even join the crowd in mocking another believer because you just don't want to be seen as different. You deny the one who died for your sins without even realizing what you've done. But when you see it, the guilt can be overwhelming. It may be hard to even step into the church knowing what a hypocrite you've been. Can a wretch like me even be saved? The answer, dear brothers and sisters, is simple. Yes, you can. For after his resurrection, Jesus confronted Peter in his denial. He did it in the form of a question. And just as Peter denied Christ three times, Jesus asked him this three times. "Do you love me?" And Peter responded affirmatively every time. "Then you've got work to do. Tend my flock, feed my sheep, and build them up." So Jesus has already dealt with the denial. He took it to the cross, along with all the other sins you've committed, along with the sins I've committed, and along with the sins of the whole world. Do you love him? Then you've got work to do. You get to share the good news. You get to tell other people about it. Don't shrink from claiming your Lord and Savior in public. He has called you to return from your denial because, as we've heard so often throughout this series, he is gracious and merciful. He's slow to anger. He's abounding in steadfast love. And because he relents over disaster, you see, your salvation is done. You are a forgiven child of God because, just as he said on the cross, it is finished. In the name of Jesus, amen. Please stand for the litany. O Lord, O Christ, O Lord, O Christ, God the Father in heaven, God the Son, Redeemer of the world, God the Holy Spirit, be gracious to us, be gracious to us. From all sin, from all error, from all evil, from the crafts and assaults of the devil, from sudden and evil death, from pestilence and famine, from war and bloodshed, from pestilence and famine, from war and bloodshed, from sedition and from rebellion, from lightning and tempest, from nation, by your holy nativity, by your baptism, fasting and temptation, by your agony and bloody sweat, by your cross and passion, by your precious death and burial, this resurrection and ascension, and by the coming of the Holy Spirit, the Comforter. In all time of our prosperity, in the hour of death, and in the day of judgment, we poor sinners implore you to rule and govern your holy Christian church, to preserve all pastors and ministers of your church in the true knowledge and understanding of your wholesome word, and to sustain them in holy living, to put an end to all schisms and causes of offense, to bring into the way of truth all who have erred and are deceived, to beat down Satan under our feet, to send faithful laborers into your harvest, and to accompany your word with your grace and spirit, to raise those who fall, and to strengthen those who stand, and to comfort and help the weak-hearted and the distressed. To give to all peoples concord and peace, to preserve our land from discord and strife, to give our country your protection in every time of need, to direct and defend our president and all in authority, to bless and protect our governor and all our people, to watch over and help all who are in danger, necessity, and tribulation, to protect and guide all who travel, to grant all women with child and all mothers with infant children increasing happiness in their blessings, to defend all orphans and widows and to provide for them, to strengthen and keep all sick persons and young children, to free those in bondage and to have mercy on us all. To forgive our enemies, persecutors, and slanderers, and to turn their hearts, to give and preserve for our use the kindly fruits of the earth, and graciously to hear our prayer.
We implore you to hear us, Lord.
Lord Jesus Christ, Son of God.
We implore you to hear us.
Christ, the Lamb of God, who takes away the sin of the world. Christ, the Lamb of God, who takes away the sin of the world. Christ, the Lamb of God, who takes away the sin of the world. O Christ, O Lord, O Christ, O Lord, Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come,
Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Let us pray. I thank you, my heavenly Father, through Jesus Christ, your dear Son, that you have graciously kept me this day. And I pray that you would forgive me all my sins where I have done wrong, and graciously keep me this night. For into your hands I commend myself, my body and soul and all things. Let your holy angel be with me, that the evil foe may have no power over me. Amen. The blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be and remain with you always. Please be seated for our last hymn. Happy St. Patrick's Day. Thank you for coming tonight. You'll notice there's a lot of lights and there's a camera in the back. Many thanks to Chris for putting all this up and everybody who helped him. Looks like it's working really well. Good transition. So glad that's working well. Other than that, just a reminder that Pastor Kristoyak will be here this next weekend to lead worship. And then one more Lenten service on Wednesday, and then we move into Palm Sunday and Holy Week. So God's gracious peace to you as you go from here tonight. Stay warm. I don't know if it's still raining or not. Drive safely, please. Okay.